Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss with you three important experiments of class 11th chemistry which are done, that is cutting a glass tube, bending a glass tube and drawing a jet. So you can just follow the instructions, look for all the precautions, listen carefully and then go to your school labs to practice the same. So let us begin. So our first experiment is cutting a glass rod of length 10 centimeter, right? So the first thing to check is I will take a smooth end. I'll feel this end of the glass rod. This is a smooth end. So I'll start from here and measure 10 centimeter from here using a scale and mark that end with a marker. So I'm keeping this here and 10 centimeter I'll make a mark. This is a 10 centimeter mark and now I'm going to make a cut here using this triangular file. This is a triangular file. It is wedge shaped. It has these three, you can see, surfaces with, this is a rough surface like a sandpaper. So we can use this surface to rub and smoothen a particular end. Okay, if your end is not smooth, if the end of the glass rod is not smooth, it can be rubbed like this with this file to make it smooth. Okay, so now I'm going to make a cut. Hold the glass tube very firmly with this finger and thumb, not excess pressure, neither too lightly, and hold this file this way and make a one strong scratch. In case you feel one is not strong enough, you can repeat one on the same point. This scratch should not be too strong, otherwise this glass tube will crash or break, and you will not give it repetitive scratches also. There should be a strong scratch at one point. And now I'm going to hold this between these two hands. This is the scratch point. I'll face it away from me, keep the thumb and finger, and just with a soft pressure break it, and I get these two halves. This is a 10 centimeter tube and I will feel the ends. The ends are smooth. In case they are not, as I told you, you can rub it or we can do fire polishing. Fire polishing is heating it in the flame. Fine. You can fire polish the end like this. Fire polishing means I'm going to heat it in the flame so that the ends get rounded. You study this fire polishing in your theory as well in liquid state chapter. So I'm just going to rotate this in flame and the end is rounded. The end gets rounded, right, and smooth. Similarly, if the other end is also not smooth, I can heat it in the flame, keep rotating so as to smoothen that end. And please be careful, cool the tube before you handle it in between two such steps. So I have fire polished, means I've rounded the edges, and this is a glass tube with 10 centimeter length cut, right? So you can observe this is a 10 centimeter long tube, glass tube cut, right? Now we will discuss how to bend a glass tube at an angle of 90 degree. Why do we need to bend? We generally bend glass tubes to create delivery tubes. So let us go ahead. So this is a glass tube. I've taken a glass tube, right? And this is a long glass tube. I'm going to bend this glass tube at an angle of 90 degree. So just say I'm going to heat this at the point I want to bend with constant swirling. In the non-luminous part of the flame, I'm going to heat this constantly like this. And the moment it feels soft, and please see that you focus heat at one point only. You don't let heat move. And now bend it to an angle of 90. I'll check the angle by putting it here, and as still hot, I can set the angle. This is a 90 degree angle. I'm checking it across the edge of this tile, the surface. Okay, and now let it cool. This is your bent glass tube. So I'm showing you another glass tube again and telling you the precautions. The first precaution is you should keep swallowing like this. The second precaution is when you have to bend it, you will only turn one hand, not both. You will not turn both hands in, only one. Keep one fixed, and with one, see, I'm just turning one, with one, without any shaking like this. There should be no shaking, because if there's a shaking, there will be a kink at this point. This point might get blocked. So there should be no shaking of hand. You will not move. See, you will not move both the hands like this. You will keep one hand fixed and just move one. Right? This is going to give you a very neat, clean bend. So this was bending a tube, and now we're going to proceed with how to draw a jet. How to draw a jet from a glass tube. So again, I'm taking a glass tube and heating it in this non-luminous part of the flame with constant swirling. And the moment it becomes soft, I'll pull the two ends apart. See, it has become soft, and now I'm going to pull the two ends apart, right? And let this end cool. And now, depending upon how much size bore I want, what is the size of the hole I want at that end, I will be making a cut on this. So I'm going to make a cut with this wedge, and depending, if I want a bigger hole, I'll cut it towards this end. If I want a smaller hole, towards the tip, and then I can fire polish this end to smoothen this end. I can fire polish to smoothen this end, and this is a jet prepared. So I'll show you how this is working like a jet. See, I'm going to pour water into this, and you can see this is now working like a jet. So you can see this is behaving like a jet. I'm sharing with you how to write down the cutting bending experiment in your copy. This is the right hand side page. You will write down to cut a glass tube of 10 centimeter length, and then the procedure, and then the precautions. This is to be written on the right hand side page. On the left hand side page, again aim, apparatus used, and diagrams. This is the next experiment. To bend a glass tube at an angle of 90 degree, again writing aim, procedure, and precautions. This is the left hand side page. Aim, apparatus, diagrams. This is the third experiment, to draw a glass jet. Again, aim, apparatus, diagram. And this is the right hand side page.